Hello, fragrance lovers. Welcome back to my channel. I'm happy to be back for another video today, and I hope it's going to be as welcomed as the other one. I think most of the impression was my intro too long. Let's go directly to the video right now, and let's start. So today's video, I'm going to talk about some story that are related to famous fragrances, because you know, I think we're talking a lot about notes, about what it feels like on your skin, things like that, but are we talking about stories behind? I don't think so. So I think we're gonna do a series like this. So I'm gonna talk about funny story, maybe more romantic and things like that. Yeah, enough talking, let's go back to the first story. Okay, for the first story, I'm going to show you a picture just after of the fragrance we're going to talk about. Talking about Givenchy, L'Interdit. I don't know if you tried it before. I did, and unfortunately, I shouldn't say that, but that's not one of my favorites. Very sweet fragrances. But I thought the story was amazing. So I basically went to Harrods one day, and one of the lady over there like explained to me the story behind the fragrance, and I was like, I want to buy it now. So let me tell you the story. The idea what they have is like the idea of Givenchy L'Interdit is basically to recreate a bit like the atmosphere of Breakfast at Tiffany, if you've seen the movie, which is my favorite one, I love that. But yeah, just to give you a hint, L'Interdit means forbidden in French. And there's a really cute story. It's basically Audrey Hepburn. She had basically a scarf, and it was like full of fragrance in it. And she left behind her the scarf when she was in the atelier of this gentleman, Hubert. She left, and Hubert came back and found the scarf, and he was like smelling it. And he was like, oh my God, that's divine. So what he does after that, he basically invites her dinner, and a fragrance that he created at the beginning, but he wanted the public to be able to wear it. So during the dinner, it's like is it possible that we could create that fragrance for everyone to buy it? And she was shocked. I've forbidden you to do that. She came back with a decision a few months after, and then L'Interdit Givenchy was launched. I think it was 1954, I'm not too sure. 1957. Right, 1957, and it's quite funny because this perfume had a massive history, because as I remember, it was discontinued in the 90s, and then it came back in 2012 or something like that. 2002, sorry. And then it was discontinued again, so there's like a long story, so they keep like on recreating another fragrance. If you did smell the classic, please let me know how it smells, because I didn't. And I've tried a new one, and I was just like, I mean, it's nice, but it's very sweet. I think a bit too sweet for me, so I'm gonna pass this way. But I just thought, you know, who wouldn't like a fragrance that smelled like Audrey Hepburn, really? So that was the first story. So let's go to the second story now. And for the second story, I wanted to talk about Lush. So if you know the cosmetic brands, they do soaps, they do shampoo, they do anything quite naturally, I think, as I remember. So really nice store, and they do fragrances. It's quite recent, because until I know this fragrance brand, because approximately 2-3 months ago, I came over there to try everything, and I bought 3 fragrances from them. My favorite, Rentless, has this one, Psychim Girls, I never know how to say it, and I had Lust. But the fragrance we're going to talk about today is called Dear John. So I don't know if you tried Dear John before, but there's actually an interesting story behind. It's a story that is actually told in a book from a biography of the Marc Constantin, which is who is the founder of Lush. And it's called Dear John, The Road to Pelindaba. If you're interested in this story, I will put a description down and you'll be able to buy it if you like it. I don't know if you know what the Dear John letter is, but I didn't know before, so anyway. So it's a letter that during the war, the wives were sending it to the soldiers to say that they found someone else. So it's actually very, very sad. So it's a symbol of loss, sadness, something very inevitable. There's someone at the door. I'm not here. So Mark Constantin, the founder, he's been abandoned when he was a baby by his dad. So he has some souvenir where his mom was on top of the stairs with a letter, probably from his father, and she was crying, and it's something that apparently like really marked Mark, really marked Mark. You know what I mean? So yeah, and he's been looking for his father during 40 years. So when he was an active perfumer, he decided to create a perfume that smelled like a dad would smell. He didn't have any idea how a dad would smell because he didn't have any. So he created actually this fragrance, and it smells like coffee, coriander, tobacco, lime. So it's quite fresh, but boozy kind of at the same time. And so for him, that's the idea of how his dad should smell. And what is really lovely, and not lovely at the same time, for this story is when he turned 60, he found his father again. And his father was in South Africa with a whole new family around him. And what Mark did is he came to him and made him smell Dear John, which apparently he did really like it. And unfortunately, 2 weeks after, his dad passed away. But it's sad, but I mean, it's a quite happy ending at the end. And because he found a whole family around him, he had sisters he never knew before. So sad, but interesting. And I didn't really fancy Dear John, the fragrance, before, but after I smelled, I understood what he meant, what the inspiration was, and what his life was, I was like, oh yeah. Okay, I really want to try it again and wear it more, and I really do appreciate much more now the fragrance, and I think I might investigate. So invest, right? But yeah, that was the second story, and now we've done that, we're gonna go to a romantic story. Okay, for this first story, I'm showing you right now a picture of the advertising of the fragrance. It's Shalimar we're going to talk about. I guess if we're talking about storytelling today and interesting stories, we have to talk about Shalimar. So yeah, it's a cult fragrance, very iconic, very oriental, exotic kind of feeling. We didn't smell Shalimar before, I'm wondering. But it's such a beautiful fragrance. It's created by Jacques Guerlain, and he created it in 1921, same day as number five. But yeah, it's basically a whole inspiration. It's a tale of romance. It's not basically Romeo and Juliet. It's not Christian and Satin. It's not Rose and Jacques. It is Shah Jahan, who was the great Indian emperor, and he fell in love with Mumtaz Mahal, and she was a princess, and they met in a beautiful garden that was called Shalimar. So I'll let you imagine all the color of India, all the opulence of the nature over there. And do you know they have all these palaces that are stunning, golden, very warm color. So the romance started in there, and it was such a beautiful love story, really, like it's like a fairy tale. And Shalimar means the temple of love, again, in Sanskrit, is the language over there. Yeah. So unfortunately, because all romantic stories have a dramatic ending, she died. So Mumtaz Mahal died after a few months of a relation. I don't know what they're doing anymore. But yeah, so he decided to build a monument for her, and this monument became the Taj Mahal. So I let you imagine how in love he was from this lady, created like something absolutely incredible just for her. And Jacques Guerlain wanted to recreate something that's got that influence, this Eastern influence, this exotic land, this romantic and romanticism and all this passion in a fragrance. So Shalima is born, and that's something very opulent, oriental. It smells like all the Orient in a bottle, which is amazing. But yeah, so that was the little story of Shah and Mumtaz, which I think it's absolutely amazing. And it makes sense, you know, when you wear it, you can picture that scene, those gardens and those two like creating their romance. So I thought today that was nice to talk about all these little stories. I might do some of the stories around fragrances. For me, it helped me to really relate to the fragrance and to create something around it. I'm much more happier when I know something that is about this fragrance, really. So I hope you did like it, and I will see you next week for another video. I don't know what it's going to be about. Probably... No, I don't know actually. So you will see. But yeah, thanks for the support again. Please subscribe to the video. Please like the video as well if you want to support me. And follow my Instagram again. I will be again over there. It's just there. But yeah, that was Clémence City Fragrance. And I will see you shortly.